Senator Bernie Sanders of Vermont. He's chair of the Senate Veterans Affairs Committee. Senator Sanders, it's really nice to see you. Thanks for being here.
My pleasure.
So overall, what is your response to these allegations about the Phoenix VA? Do you feel like, as chair of the Veterans Committee in the Senate, do you feel like you have a handle on how serious these allegations are and what really happened?
Well, Rachel, the allegations are very, very serious. As you noted, the director of the hospital denies them. What is going on now is exactly the right thing. The Inspector General of the VA, an independent entity, is going down there. They're in Phoenix right now, and they're going to do an exhaustive investigation to get to the truth of the matter. And what I have said and say again, that as soon as that investigation is completed, we're going to do a hearing or a series of hearings on what has happened in Phoenix. So I think we're moving in the right direction. We're going to get the facts, and we're going to go forward with hearings after we get the facts.
What seemed troubling to me, I've been following this story since it first broke in the Arizona papers and people first started covering it nationally. What seemed like a troubling development to me was when we had the head of healthcare for the VA say, yeah, we sent people to Phoenix. This is not the Inspector General's office. This is the person who is the head of the healthcare within the system. We looked into it. We don't think there's anything to it. We don't see any evidence of a parallel waiting system or any effort to game the system in terms of the waiting times. And then basically, immediately after those claims were made within the VA, the Inspector General asked the secretary to suspend three top employees at that system. That sounds like two very different interpretations of the same problem.
Well, maybe, Rachel, maybe and maybe not. I think what the secretary wants to see happen is an independent investigation. What the Inspector General's office has said is that they can pursue that investigation best if they put on administrative leave the leaders of the hospital so they can go unimpeded, if you like, into all of the records. So I think that is the right thing to do. But I'll tell you one thing that does concern me, Rachel, and I agree with much of what you said in your opening remarks about the VA. There are some 300,000 VA employees, many of them veterans, working in 151 medical centers and 900 primary health care facilities. And what a whole lot of independent studies have said is that the quality of care that veterans are receiving at the VA and all of these facilities, by and large, is good quality care. In many respects, it is better than the care received at private hospitals and in many ways more cost effective. And the VA, in a number of areas, is doing some cutting edge work on telehealth, using complementary and alternative medicine, infection prevention, et cetera, et cetera. So we have got to take a hard look, an objective look at what's going on in Phoenix. And if these allegations are true, if we find that they are true, we are going to deal with it and deal with it in a very, very strong way. In my view, people who have put their lives on the line to defend this country deserve the best quality health care available. And I'm going to fight to make sure that that happens and that abuses, alleged abuses, such as we are hearing from Phoenix, do not occur anyplace else.
I think it's an important contextual point, and you see that in the patient satisfaction surveys when you compare how people feel about their private health care versus what people are getting from the VA, and you see how it often rates comparably or even better in those satisfaction surveys, and I take that point exactly. I wonder, though, with the attention that has been paid, particularly to the issue of the disability claims backlog and also the wait times for veterans to get into services at the VA. I wonder if the pressure on that, and I think the VA has felt political pressure to get those numbers down, to improve those numbers, if there is a risk that by accident, Washington has created an incentive system where VA administrators at the local level feel like they have to lie about those problems in order to hold on to their jobs.
Well, that is something we have to take a look at, and I hope it is not true. But I also have to point out something to you, Rachel, that I think you know. Washington is now very, very highly politicized. You got a whole lot of Republicans who want to repeal Obamacare. They want to end Medicare as we know it. The Ryan Republican budget in the House made savage cuts in Medicaid. You have Republican governors all over this country who do not want to expand Medicaid to their people, with the result that a lot of people or some people will die because they don't get into the doctor's office when they should. And within that context and that anti-government mentality that many Republicans have, I fear very much that there might be a politicalization of the VA. So we want to look at any and every problem that exists in the VA. But as you indicated, let's be frank, the VA is a socialized healthcare system. And I think it is fair to say that most Republicans are not terribly enthusiastic about socialized healthcare systems. So I think one of the fears that I have is that some of the overall criticisms of the VA, and I'm not talking about what's going on in Phoenix, that is a serious allegation that we have to look at, may be political. So that's something that we have to keep in mind.
Senator Bernie Sanders of Vermont, thank you very much for joining us tonight. And please stay in touch with us on this issue. It's got a lot of people very concerned, and I know that you're taking it very seriously, sir. Thank you.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you. All right. Lots coming up tonight, including something important about what you're going to be doing this weekend that you might not know about yet. Stay with us.